So you want to teach, hit the big time. Maybe not today on Zippy Point.
Quick Zips by Zippy Point.
Quick and dirty.
I'm Brock Romanek. I'm a big fan of yous. So this big guide is about being an adjunct professor, not being a full-time professor. I'll do another big guide sometime with a full-time professor and they can tell you what that's about. But this is about something I've had experience with. I've never been a full-time professor, so I couldn't talk to that. So the first thing you want to do is ask yourself, why do I want to teach? If you're doing it for the glamour, for the money, you can just stop watching this video right now. But if you want to give back to the community, to teach others, to be inspired by young people on occasion, keep on watching. So then you have to decide whether you have time to teach. It actually might take more time than you realize to teach, certainly the first time around. There's the actual time slot you're teaching, and if it's not virtual teaching, you're doing it in person, of course, your travel time. So even if it's once a week for an hour and a half at night, that's one night a week you're going to be away from your family, from your dog, just from whatever you like to do. So it's a commitment. And then there's the prep time, of course, for each class. That's going to dwarf the time you're going to spend in class, particularly that first year when you're needing, when you're crafting your materials for the first time. Sure, you might use a textbook, but maybe not. You're maybe just putting together piecemeal materials for each class, and it's just a hassle. But then you need the lesson plan itself, and that's hard because you want to be engaging. You want to offer war stories that offer practice points. It's just not an easy thing to do. Now, you can jumpstart your process if you reach out to others who have already taught. You drop them a line so you're not reinventing the wheel. But I'll tell you, if you're not a fellow full-time professor, you'd be surprised how hard it is to get a response from a full-time professor if you email them cold. They tend to be folks, in my experience, that do the bare minimum. They're teaching, they're focused, just like all of us. Where do we have our full-time jobs, and why? I don't want to be responsive to the entire world out there just because my email address happens to be on the law school's website. But please prove me wrong. But over the years, I've reached out to quite a lot of full-time professors, telling them about the blog, about one of their studies, ask them a question or two, zero response, zero response. And I'm about to plug their study. You'd think they would want that marketing, but you know, maybe they'd never heard of me, and maybe they heard of me and they don't like me. I don't care. I don't know. They don't care about me. So you might have better luck with adjunct professors, reaching out to them to have them share their materials. But try full-time professors. Prove me wrong. All right, so here's a big one. It's likely your students are not going to care. This is a killer because I always dreamed I'd be teaching in my waning days, the days that I'm in right now. And I wanted to have witty conversations with the youth, you know, the youth that were so hungry to learn. No, they're not so hungry to learn. No more than I was back in the day, and probably less. And these days, they can learn from so many other sources, like my vid guides. They only need you because you have the power to give them a grade. Now, there are exceptions, but that's what they are. They're exceptions in my experience of students that are really eager to engage with you, to go back and forth and make the class time exciting, to make conversation outside the class. But all the times I taught, I never had, one or two emails with students outside of the class. And never a phone call, zero. And I think I'm pretty engaging. I was teaching like the way I am now. Hey, rah, rah. Anyways, don't do it for the money, because there is no money. I think I made less than $2,000 per semester. This is for an adjunct professorship. Now, that was a decade ago, so I imagine it's up to $2,500 now. Enough said. How to land the teaching gig. So you're going to reach out to the places where you want to teach. That's obvious. You let the dean in charge of hiring the adjuncts know that you're available. It might not be the top dean. There's usually associate deans, assistant deans, maybe. So you find out who that person is. Maybe even just, you know, if it wasn't COVID time, you just walk over to the school if it's in your area and let them see a face. You might be able to get sort of an interview just so they could see that you're normal, right? Like, I don't know, that could be a little bit weird just to walk in, but maybe not. Also, you want to reach out to the adjunct professor who's actually teaching the class you want to teach. Let them know that you're ready and available to step in when they leave. They might be thinking of leaving, and maybe you being available gives them a nice way out. Because after a few years of teaching, adjunct professors normally want to get out for all the reasons I've mentioned, the workload, the no pay, the fact that the students care un poco. I almost forgot to tell you how I got my teaching gig. So the first time was an executive MBA class, executive MBA. So those are older students. They're like 40 years old. At the time, I was about 45. It was for corporate governance. So it was sort of novel. This is like 15 years ago. Nell Minow invited me for lunch. She lives in the neighborhood. During lunch, she asked me to take over for the class she was teaching. So I went with her to a couple of the classes. It was great to see her teach, and then I agreed to do it. And then about 5 years later, and I did that for a couple of years, and then I was like, I'm done with this. And then I got a call from, actually an email from someone I know, someone I don't even know that well, saying, hey, would you like to teach this law school class on securities laws? Because the dude who was supposed to teach had just caught for some criminal activity. He can't teach. So I agreed to do it. I met with the associate dean, and I roped in Jay Knight, who was at the SEC at the time, to be my co-teacher, and we taught that class together, I guess for only 1 year, maybe it was 2 years, I can't remember. And that was it, man. That was it. And then think about non-traditional ways of teaching. Come teach on zippypoint.com. You'll reach a worldwide audience. And the pay is about right. I ain't going to pay you a cent. Seriously, hit me up, and I'd be happy to showcase your talents in some way on this platform. Have a little fun. It's fun, man, talking to your computer with no one else in the room. No one's staring down at their computer pretending they're taking notes, but they're playing solitaire or online Yahtzee.